Hey, I've been working on some commercial projects recently, that's why I haven't really had a chance to post any videos, but something unusual happened on this one. Working on a, well actually I can't really tell you what it does, but it required some tantalum caps, and that's really the focus of this right here. And this right here is a tantalum cap. Of course, this one is a bad tantalum cap, see how it's black? And this one was actually faring better than the other one. The other one literally exploded and sent flying shrapnel everywhere, including one that hit my eyelid. Thankfully, I had my safety squints on. Not messing around anymore. These are Chinese tantalum capacitors, and they are specified very clearly. These ones are specified to be, let's see here, 220 microfarad. 16 volt tantalum caps, and either that's a lie or something's backward or, well, something, because the DigiKey tantalum caps work perfectly and these don't. So I guess I'm gonna just find out if I got really unlucky with the first two, that they were just, you know, the only two bad ones in the bunch, or if, you know, more of these explode. I'm just kind of curious here. Just hope I didn't get super unlucky with those two, because that would be depressing. Now, the reason I tried these Chinese caps was because they were almost 10 times cheaper than the DigiKey counterparts. See, I'm gonna start with the power supply off, and then I'm going to hook this up. But one thing, if you are ever gonna use a tantalum cap, you should be careful of, is to make sure that you have the right side positive. For some reason, the line indicates positive on these tantalum caps.
The positive electrode
makes me nervous. So it's hooked up. I'm gonna go crank this to 12 volts and see if it explodes. Ah! Okay, so that exploded and shorted, probably a little bit above 12. Oof. So you can see it's still glowing red hot from that, well, now it's not anymore. But that was a little disturbing. Now mind you, these are fresh. These have never been soldered. They are straight from AliExpress. Thought I was gonna get a super deal on them, and well, most of the time I do, but did not work out for the best this time. So let's turn it on. Okay, I'm gonna start putting some voltage in, and I'm gonna stop this around 12 volts, and I'm not gonna just keep going. Ugh, makes me so nervous. Maybe they just marked them backward. Oh, I should not put my face that close. The other thing is, I'm worried that these electrodes might have, gotten crud on them, so I'm gonna go put fresh ones down here. Plug in. Start turning it up. Oh! It is conducting real hard, so it was just the electrodes that was the problem. So that has got the polarity right. That's just a terrible cap. You can see it. It's drawn 4 amps at 2.8 volts. So, no, these are definitely marked right as far as plus and minus. It's just they are not rated for 16 volts. Bummer. Well, let's blow another one up for good measure. Okay, so 7 volts isn't gonna do it. Whoa! See, what voltage was that when I finally blew? 15 volts. So, did not even make the rated voltage. Let's record at 60 FPS and see if we can get what one of these 470 microfarad tantalum caps says. That is terrifying.
10. And 13 volts.
One more for good measure.
1, 2, 3, 4. 14. 15. Okay, it's probably not connected. Probably got some crud on my tips here.
Okay, let's try that again.
8, 9, 10, 15, 16. I think it's withstanding 16 volts.
Hey, check that out. This one actually survived. It's slowly ramping down. So, at least one of these capacitors might be okay at the rated voltage. That does not instill confidence. So now I'm going to try it with this, 100 microfarad rated at 16 volt. Let's see if this one explodes. Actually, all I really need for this project is a bunch of 100 microfarads. So if it works, I'm set.
Maximum voltage this should ever see is about 15 volts. Hooking it up. Ooh. Sparks went flying.
That was more than sparks. Well, that's a failure. You might be thinking, Charles, of course this is going to happen. You just bought parts from who knows where and totally unvetted and all of that, and that's why you should always buy parts through known providers. And that's only kind of half true. A lot of times the price difference really does make up for the loss of reliability and, well, predictability. The only thing, though, is it does show that on any kind of part that is prone to explosions, you probably should check to make sure that it is the right thing.